Now, a medical student in Lancaster who felt let down by health professionals treating her eating disorder is reaching out to her fellow student doctors with a film giving an insight into her illness.
She enlisted the help of Fixers. That's, of course, the campaign that gives young people a voice in the hope that she can improve understanding in the future.
Who am I?
Who am I?
What have I become?
What have I become?
Who am I? Who am I?
Being trapped in an eating disorder makes you feel very alone and hopeless. At times, I got so unwell, my parents were worried about my life and were worried if I would wake up in the morning.
Just some attention seeker.
An overweight mess.
Someone who stays close to a bathroom so they can vomit the last meal.
It's really difficult when the people around you who you need to help you don't really understand. Sometimes just for someone to acknowledge that you're having these thoughts is all you need. I'm Harriet Davis, I'm 25 and I'm a medical student at Lancaster University. I'm working with Fixers to improve understanding on eating disorders and particularly in the medical profession.
Eat something. What's your problem? You don't look like you have an eating disorder.
I've created a film to help highlight some of the unhelpful assumptions that people make.
Don't you have any self-control?
You're so skinny. It can't be healthy looking the way you do.
It's time you grew out of it.
It started when I was about 14 and I started dieting to lose a bit of weight for a holiday and it quickly escalated. My mum took me to the doctor, but I was told that I looked fine and he'd seen a lot worse. And he didn't even refer me to any mental health services, which meant I just got worse and ended up in hospital. And now that I study medicine, I've come to recognise the strain and the pressure that doctors are under. But I'd like other people to get help sooner so that they can have less of the physical and mental consequences.
There are over 70,000 people in Lancashire with an eating disorder at any one time. There's an assumption that it's about being thin, it's about vanity, and it really isn't. It's a mental illness. So there needs to be a lot more understanding, a lot more education for GPs. It's so important for that early intervention.
When the people we depend on assess us
on our appearances and not what goes on
inside our minds.
Today I'm showing my film to a group of medical students.
I'm a victim of silence.
I'm a product of social peer pressure.
I'm a complex web of genetics, perfectionism and trauma.
I'm one of many.
I'm someone close to you.
I could be anyone.
I could be anyone.
I thought it was really good because you couldn't see the people at first, so you get to like understand their psychological viewpoint before you kind of judge them, I suppose.
It really gets across the kind of striking nature of what's actually going on inside, which you don't normally see.
It's quite common in medicine that you just start to see a condition rather than the person that it's affecting, and it really brought to light the person beneath the illness.
If I managed to make a difference to even one doctor's knowledge or to one person's experience, it would be good to know that I've made something of a bad experience and to help others have less of a difficult journey than I've had.
On our website, you'll find advice for where to go for support and information on eating disorders, itv.com/Granada.